pick the number of A's you want called by me. So this is me. I'm Ori Pekelman. I'm Ori Pekelman everywhere, GitHub, LinkedIn. I have a blog. I made the logo. I'm quite proud of it. So while researching this presentation, yes, I do research even lightning talks. I thought that it would be cool to code something, because in open source world, well, code is gold. And I thought, well, for what I'm going to talk about, all I need to do is kind of generate a badge with some text on it. So not the hardest thing in the world. I do kind of code in Ruby. Not only Ruby, but also Ruby. And so I kind of, okay, I'll do that in, you know, a small Rails application. It's gonna take an hour or so. Google, please tell me what to do. Google, Rails, dynamic, image, gem. So I do kind of, I haven't done anything like that for a year or so. So I do know the name of the gems and that are around for doing that. But, well, that changes a lot, right? There are cool ones, less cool ones. So what happens next is the real subject. I Googled, got to Stack Overflow, and a heading, I found the question, which is the correct one, heading into 2013, should I use Dragonfly paperclip or carrier wave? Yeah. The question, I'm just another average Joe. I want to do that. What should I use? Answer from Nick. With 63 issues open and no activity for 9 months, considering you ask on heading to 2013, I don't see Dragonfly being part of the future. And thanks, may I know which one you prefer? Not constructive, bye-bye. So that's it. And so now, what do we do? We study ourselves, right? We go to GitHub, and Dragonfly. I prefer Dragonfly, personally. Because I don't want to have the model adherence, and my problem is just, you know, showing 4 characters of text and stuff. I look on that, and, you know, 31 minutes ago! And it's alive, and it's beautiful. And so, first of all, thanks Mark Evans for maintaining Dragonfly. And I can't really see you guys, so who's, well, okay, Nicola. Can you please kind of stand up and say, thank you, Mark?
Thank you, Mark.
So, and now, thank you, Nicola. I wanted to use that. I don't know if you guys know Nicola, but Nicola published a bunch of gems. Some of them are really, really interesting. Nicola Merouz, for those who don't know him. And but we do have a problem here. And so we spend too much time worrying whether our stuff is maintained or not. I wanted to use Kanban. It's kind of a HipChat clone. But I tweeted. I looked at GitHub, not maintained 3 months. I don't know. Tweeted, didn't respond, didn't use it. All of these clues, the Travis, the code climate, all of this stuff is something that takes a lot of time and out of fear. We don't use stuff, but even more, 16 seconds. This time I'm not on time. So, more importantly, so we put undue, undeserved, unhelpful pressure on maintainers. It's always good to publish code. And being blamed for not maintaining is shit, and it's not nice. So we need to find ways to make this better. So I'm proposing R, Adoption Agency for Abandoned Repos. Look at it on my GitHub. It's just an idea. I did put some code on, but it doesn't do anything. And so, and there are a bunch of other slides there. If you, you might know, there is a project like this called Still Maintained. It's basically the same idea. I just didn't know about it. And I think, I've learned that a bunch of you don't know about it. So maybe this is just, we should do kind of pull requests to Still Maintained, and that's all. Sorry, I'm over time. There were ponies, there were squirrels, there were other stuff. Thank you very much. Come on, come on.